So in this presentation, I will focus on field service as a topic today. So getting into the key trends, so what are the trends that we see in the market with respect to very specific to the field service industry? So these were the trends which were there for quite a long time. But now, because of this pandemic situation, we see the acceleration of this trend. So I will take you through these trends and what can be the opportunities that can be for your organization. First is on the new business model evolution. So now on the service front, we see the Uberization of service is becoming rapid now. The organizations are adopting this freelancer model very, very rapidly. So this we see basically a very, very high attraction in the market. The second topic, what we also see, companies are also moving from a product company to a solution company. So this is also driven by the customer requirement to say that I want to go with a pay-per-use model. So customers are looking at a more an OPEX spending for their capital intensive equipments. They don't want to make upfront commitment and investment. So this is also triggering a sort of a new set of a business opportunities for the organization. The second trend which we see, which has accelerated now, customers are saying, okay, know me better. So they are not okay to go with the current AMC model which is being operated. So customers are not okay to say that there is a fixed service, there is a fixed component as part of my contract. Customers are looking at what can be the specialized predictive maintenance services that you can provide to me. So why can't you alert me when there is going to be a potential breakdown or a failure? Why can't you come and fix it before the failure happens? So basically, there is a completely shift from the customer expectation to move away from the AMC model. And other also we see the adoption wise, customers are also willing to move into an outcome based model. For example, customer is willing to share a sort of a outcome based profit. In case, for example, if you are in an industry where it is a capital intensive equipment, for a 0% breakdown, if you are going able to achieve in a year, they are willing to share the outcomes and the rewards with you. So that's also a pretty unique trend which is evolving now. So if you get into the other part of it, the contactless sales, now it is becoming normal now with commerce channels coming in. And because of the current situation, the sales are happening remotely. So customers are getting familiarized with this channel. So now the field service becomes a very, very critical touch point now. So this is an opportunity for the organizations to cross-sell, upsell the products. So from a function perspective, the field service was more considered as a support function. Now this is evolving into a major function now. The last trend is on the knowledge commoditization part of it. So previously, every company have their own knowledge which is residing in silos. Now we see it as an opportunity to how do we bring all the collective knowledge together and how do we provide that knowledge to the field service personnel when they are performing the service. So that's becoming more an opportunity to improve the basic quality, on-time schedule delivery. So those are all the things, the knowledge commoditization, there is a huge opportunity to improve the customer experience. So currently with the challenges that is available in the current situation, what are all the challenges faced by the customers to realize new opportunities? So the first challenge what we see, which continues to be there, is how do we identify the right technician for performing a repair or service? So now with the technology coming in, products are becoming very complex. There is a specialized skill required for each of the product. How do you identify your right technician to perform the service or a repair is becoming more and more important. And if you look at it on a KPI perspective, this has a significant impact. If you look at it on the first time right percentage, so still it is 95% is the first time average for the average scores of the companies. So still there is a lot of opportunities to improve the first time right scores. The second challenge is the incentive and compensation has been more or less available for a lot of sales teams. If you typically look at it on the service, there are only very few companies who have a structured incentive compensation model to differentiate high performing service personnel. This is also resulting in the higher attrition of the skilled technicians. And if you take this attrition of your distributor, dealers and network, this percentage will be significantly higher. The third common challenge which we see, the field service applications are not tightly integrated with any of the ERP backend. So now the organizations are looking at building their own capabilities, digital capabilities. This also has quite a lot of integration related challenges. So this is hampering the unified service experience to the customer. So to manage this challenge, what customers are doing now is they are looking at a process. They are putting more controls. For example, if you have a warranty claim which needs to be done for a repair, there are a lot of checks and controls which are put in place. So unfortunately, what this happens is this increases the turnaround time, and this also has an impact on the service performance. So the fourth topic, the knowledge. Now, if you look at it with the channels where they are evolving, so how do we provide the right type of knowledge while the technician when he is on the field? So this directly has an impact to the customer satisfaction scores. Now, if you look at the average score, still it's at 80%. So if you look at it on the challenges, so the organizations are struggling with to meet the basic customer requirements because of these various challenges. Yeah, how do we see the future experience centric service model evolving? So if you look at it, there are five major players in this, which are available even now. So the brands are there, the service centers are there, service technicians, the non-exclusive or the freelancers and the customers. The major change that is happening in the service model is now the brands or the OEMs have a lot of direct interaction with the customers. So also the freelancer as a model is also evolving. Now the freelancers are also directly interacting with the companies. So if you look at it on the earlier scenarios, the freelancers were assigned to the authorized service centers and they were responsible for their management. Now that is getting slowly shifted to the companies. So what does this mean is basically they have an ecosystem where the informations are shared across the ecosystem. You have a visibility of the warranty processes, warranty claims that has been raised, the customer history, what was the service performance, what is the availability of the spare stock. So that everything is possible with digital technologies connecting all those five blocks which are in the organization model, and it is making the communication and the interaction seamless. So also now, if you look at it now, the AI and human intelligence now coexist. There are a lot of capabilities that can be developed with artificial intelligence and also with the machine learning capabilities that are available. So this will also significantly improve the customer engagements, the service processes as well. So this experience-centric model, what are all the advantages the organization can look for? So a couple of basic things on the call handling time. Now, if you call up any of the call center's agents, currently they don't have the right information because of the fragmented landscape and the information that is available. With this seamless information, if you're a customer calling, all your information can be retrieved at a click, and they will be able to create a ticket without asking too many information from you. So now also on a turnaround time, also now if you look at it, there are a lot of channels available for the customer to directly interact with OEMs. So there are chatbots where customers can have a ticket created directly. There can be an IoT device from where the ticket can be created. So basically there are a lot of channels opening up which will reduce the turnaround time. And also with current ML and AI capabilities, there is a good opportunity to identify who can be the right technician, what is the scheduling availability of that person, and he can be assigned to the ticket as soon as the ticket is created without a manual intervention. So all this is going to significantly, one, reduce the service operation cost because the inefficiencies that are in the process are getting eliminated. Second, there is also an opportunity to cross-sell, upsell with the interactions with the customers increasing day by day. So this is a model which we see that it is going to evolve in the future. So looking at on how SAP addresses all this service movements. So on the bottom box of it, you see the enterprise applications, which are backend application. You may have an SAP ERP or which can be an ECC or a S4. And there is a machine learning capability or the digital capabilities, I will put it. SAP Leonardo platform provides you all your advanced digital capabilities. So on the left side, on the service self-service movement is basically a no-touch point for the customer. are going to increase. So SAP provides a capability with the conversational AIs where the chatbots can interact directly with the customers. The IoT device can be directly integrated to the systems to create those tickets automatically. So that's one where you see it on the left. So where on the middle, where you see it's a sort of a medium touch point will continue to be there. The customer call centers, wherever the organizations are having, will continue to have those call centers. But the engagement levels in those customer call centers can be significantly different from what it is now. So SAP provides a solution for that, which is called SAP Cloud for Service, which it provides the capabilities on the complete interaction center, and also all the advanced AI ML capabilities are part of the solution. To give you some of the example, for example, I am a customer, I am raising a ticket. So based on the history and also based on the pattern, I can get a customized do-it-yourself checklist to say that these are all some 10 things, can you please check and confirm me back whether it is working. So this is possible, it can be customized for each of the customer. Second, if I look at it, if I am a service supervisor or a service manager, how do I get a predictive analysis on what can be the potential customer escalation points? So SAP provides the analytic capabilities where you can look at it on what are all the potential tickets which can have an escalation. And then upfront, you can start working on those rather than waiting for a customer complaint. So the third element also, if you look at it on how do I route my tickets to the right technicians? So that's also can be possible with an ML solution where based on the skill set, availability of the people, the right tickets can be assigned. So those are all the capabilities which will get enhanced with the cloud service solution. On the last part of it, where it is a high touch point, where this is where the field technician visits the site and has an interaction with the customer. So there, SAP offers a solution where it's a crowd service based solution where you can add freelancers into the model. They can be part of the solution. You will be able to track the interactions. You will be able to have a view on how they are performing on each of the tickets. So that is a functionality which SAP offers. And it also offers the digital capabilities where when a field technician visits the customer, he can record the feedback. He can generate an invoice when he is in the field. There can be a digital signature. There is a whole lot of digital capabilities which are available on the field service solutions. The other part which I did not cover is on the litmus solution part of it. Litmus is on how do we have a sort of a continuous learning platform. So based on all the interactions we have, how do we customize our training programs that can suit to each of the individuals rather than be a generic program which has to be applied across the complete roles. Litmus helps in identifying the specific requirement for individuals, identify what are all the potential weak areas, which are all the areas to be trained, and the customized solutions can be pushed into each of the individuals as part of Litmus. So this is a host of the capabilities which SAP offers you to move towards the future experience-centric service model. So now I will request for a short video. Before that, I will just give you a little bit context on this. So Blueprint, we have developed a solution, a custom solution on top of the current SAP solution, which I discussed. So this is a lightweight solution, a pre-configured solution that has been developed with using SAP Service Cloud and the Field Service Cloud. And it also provides an enhanced capability. For example, I know quite a lot of your organizations may be using the dealer management or a distribution management solution. So which is not integrated and there is no real visibility of the spare parts availability. So what we have done is we have developed a lightweight dealer portal where you have a real-time visibility of the spare parts, the field service technicians availability. Those are all the components which are available as part of the solution. And this is a solution which can be quickly deployed in a very, very short time frame. So I request Justin to play the video, please.
A quick summary of the solution that we presented to you. One, it enables faster time to market. This solution can be deployed in your environment with a 12 to 16 weeks lead time. Second, it provides you a visibility of your channel and also the complete service operations. That is second. Third, it gives you the enhanced customer experience because it is enabling you the self-service options, the customer service. So that is how we see this as a solution that can help you in moving to your future experience-centric service model. Thanks for your attention. Thank you. If there are any questions, I'm willing to take it.
Thank you for your insightful session, Mr. Vaidyeshwaran. Attendees, it's time for the QA. If you have any questions, please use the chat panel to share your questions. And while we wait for questions, next up we have a keynote again on CX, the ever-changing paradigm, and a response by Mr. Vikas Kumar, the VP and head of operations transformation, Capgemini. In Men India, we will be having the keynote started just after this session. Mr. Vaidyeshwaran, I don't see any questions coming through, and I believe we could conclude the keynote.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. If you could please go back to the main launch area.